So one of the things I have been waiting for quite a lot this half year is more fog here in Denmark. And when I saw on the weather apps that there'll be predicted fog for like the entire area around where I live, I was like, yes, it's out taking pictures. So yesterday I was in this part of the woods and just to explore. I've only been here a few times, so I had to do some preparations. And I walked around for 2-3 hours just to find interesting places to photograph, interesting subjects, interesting compositions. So it's a little bit past sunrise and I'm here at my first subject, which is a small beech tree surrounded by pine trees, and it's just so beautiful. It's so atmospheric. All the fog and mist and haze and whatever you call it in the background just makes so much separation and so much atmosphere, and the scene is just so simple and calm, and I will hardly need to do anything with this one in post-processing. So when it comes to my woodland photography, my main goal is to try to transfer that calm serenity of the forest. This is as far from epic as you can get, and this was how I did manage to say epic in my video anyway. But this is just so serene and ethereal and calm, and I'm in love with this. This is so nice. So the next one I've come to here is an old birch tree, which is fairly gnarly, and I like that. And there's even like a hole right there in the middle, which obviously will be the focal point of the photo. But I will have to, well, I am mingling a little bit around with the camera just to try a few different compositions. I really, really like this tree and the mist. It goes very much hand in hand, like some old fairy tale forest. I really like this. So I have tried one a little bit lower to the ground, and then I've also tried one a little bit higher up. I will try a few more different compositions and then let's see what happens. Mm-hmm. So I've come out in the more open, and there's this pretty nice scene here behind me. And this is a scene that obviously does not benefit from the fog, because the silver birch that I'm trying to photograph is so far away that obviously it's behind the fog. There's too much fog between me and the silver birch. And it's fairly close to the background trees. The background trees are dark and it is bright, so it should stand out, but it doesn't really because of all the fog. It's just like a flat scene. So either I should come back when the fog has lifted, or come back later in the autumn when all the leaves of the silver birch has turned yellow. It does happen that I'm just completely wrong, and this was actually such a case. With a fairly aggressive use of the DHA slider in camera raw, I managed to pull out a photo from this place that I really, really like. The photo is just so atmospheric. It's also simple because of the central composition, but at the same time powerful because of the panoramic crop. It goes to show yet again you can try and predict photos all you want and use all the logical principles about photography you've learned, and you can still surprise yourself. I honestly didn't think I'd even get a photo here, but this lone silver birch among the pine trees, standing on a blooming field of heather, might have turned out to be my favorite photo from this morning. So I will just spend 2 seconds talking about my ebook. I have an ebook which I've spent a good part of the summer making, and it's on composition in landscape photography. To all of you who have already bought it, thank you so much. I greatly appreciate it. And if you're interested in it, there is a link down in the description. Now, if you are not sure if you want to spend $20 on an ebook on composition, I have also made a light version, and you can get that one by signing up to my newsletter. I've already sent it out to everyone on my newsletter list, so that should be fine. And then you can see from there if you would like to get the real one, the non-light one. So yeah, there's some links down in the description. So the sun has come up and the fog has disappeared. There's a little bit left in the air, as you can see here in the sunbeams. But generally, I think I'm done for this morning. It has been an absolutely beautiful morning, and I think I've got some really, really nice photos. At least a couple I'm very, very happy about. So this was the second episode of Tales from the Forest, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, as always, I would highly appreciate both a like and a comment.